What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? Thank you so much for tuning in. It's me, Mikey Pipes. Wednesday, August 20th, 2025. I'm about to take you on a service call with a brand new hire. He's going to be our senior plumbing technician here at Pipe Doctor Home Services. A few years older than me. He's got a couple decades of military experience, so we're very proud of his service to our country, and I'm very happy that I'm hiring a veteran. This is going to be his first service call. We're working on a Weil McLain Ultra 3, $399, that's got a bad Extrol number 60, but most importantly, it was never installed properly. I'm going to show you step by step how we take care of things the right way at Pipe Doctor. And remember, if you're tired of getting bamboozled by your HVAC contractor and you live in the Long Island, New York City metropolitan area, pick up the phone, you know what to do. Let's go.
Good morning.
How are you today?
How are you? May we come
okay.
in?
Yes.
Okay.
As you know, I'm Mike.
Yes, I know.
This is John.
Hello.
He is one of our new plumbers on staff. And we're here to replace that expansion tank for you. All right.
Okay.
Now, I was not here for that initial diagnosis. Daniel said it's quite easy to swap out. So I'm going to take a quick peek at that and verify that. I have the expansion tank in the truck. The tank is like 480 and change.
Guys,
if it's really as easy as I said it's going to be, I'm not going to charge you a full hour of labor. I'll charge you like the trip charges, $115.
Okay.
Okay. So just I want to be fair, and I also want to take a quick peek at the generator.
Right.
I'm not saying they didn't do they know what they're doing, but I like to always follow behind because I usually set a service generator,
yes.
Not them. But
yes.
I also want to take a quick peek at that as well while we're here. Okay.
Yes.
All right. So we will be downstairs.
Okay.
If there's any problems, I'll let you know.
Yep.
I don't foresee anything.
Right.
But how's everything else? Good.
Yeah, it's a little hectic. Micah, hold on.
Okay. All right, we'll be downstairs.
Okay, thanks.
You're welcome. All right. So, they have a Weil McLain Ultra 3. This is maybe a 230 or a 399, but it's a big boiler.
Yes.
Probably a 399, I'm gonna guess. Especially with the indirect.
And there's a tank back
there. And there's the tank that's back there. That Daniel says is easy to replace. However, there's one thing I want to point out here is that it's installed in the wrong orientation.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I am a big stickler with
the down direction.
Yes.
Going up.
The downward direction is where it needs to be, but I'm not gonna reinvent the wheel here because there's really no easy way of putting it the right way unless we repipe stuff here.
Exactly. We shut the fast fill off.
Yes. So what I'm gonna do is we're gonna tell her that, hey, listen, you know, I don't know if Daniel mentioned it, but it's really installed in the wrong orientation, but it's been like that forever. And leave it up to her. Like if she wants, we could probably take out this relief valve
right
here and come out with a nipple, a three-quarter yep. nipple, three-quarter by half-inch T here, and then still put the relief valve in there. Right. And then it'll be hanging where it is, and it'll be supported by the pipe, or we can do something there. But now that X job is now X plus XXX.
But,
right. All right, folks, believe it or not, we are going to do this the right way. That expansion tank that's located there, we're going to cap that off, that line there. We'll just keep the valve closed and cap that off. But the expansion tank is going to get relocated to here. We're going to come out, taking out this three-quarter inch street 90. We're going to come out with an elbow at 90, three-quarter by half-inch T, and then another elbow coming out of the top of it for our relief valve because they need to be installed vertically. And we'll somehow secure it with some threaded rod, but I'm here with John. We're getting the job done. Remember, if you need a plumber, you live in the Long Island area,
Look no further. Call Pipe Doctor, 516-348-6300. Let's get the show on.
All right. Valves closed. Valves closed. That's a purge for the primary loop. Let's close off this indirect, which is going to be our return, indirect return, indirect supply. That's closed. That's closed. If we open up that valve, we can drain. I'm right here. I'm good. Ready?
Yeah, man.
Beautiful. Now, that expansion tank, right? You feel like taking a shower today? You feel like doing it the smart way?
I released the pressure.
Oh, okay.
When you were talking, I was...
Yeah, I know. I noticed. So, if you hook up a tool that's in your truck called the Milwaukee M12 inflator, hook it up to there, open up that valve, and purge all the water out of it.
We can do that too.
You want to do it?
Yeah, why do I need to sell?
So, there are some people on the internet
that
I'm not going to name that have YouTube channels.
Yeah.
That are plumbers.
Yeah.
You know what they do? How they empty these things out? They stab it with a screwdriver.
Yeah. Smart.
So, I learned this trick taking a pump, and that's threaded on completely. You can open that valve. And you start that pump, and then, hit the other button now. Oh, hold on, stop for a second. We have our system isolated. That's here, so I'm gonna open this up.
Yep.
There's a check valve here. Let's open up the other one. Primary loop. Check valve. It's on the supply side.
This is return.
If I open these up, okay, let's see. Let me open it up anyway. Okay.
No problem. There you go.
And we'll force all the water out of that tank. And we will remove the tank in a drip-free fashion. Works every time. Oh, got lucky there. I was thinking while I was watching that, I was like, is the lever go the other way or is it going to go down? And sure enough, it went down.
Did you close?
Yeah. I closed it, yeah. See, we're changing the expansion tank, and it's a great time to put it in the right way. Excellent. And a tight spot. I did tap on the side of the tank and it felt like it was like empty, but just be careful.
I don't know how we're gonna get this out. Let's come on.
We may go down straight down there with it, maybe.
We got water.
Yeah, how much? Turn it the other way. Wow, a lot of water. Not that much. All right, folks. Came out with a 6-inch 3/4 nipple, the 90, a 5-inch, another 90, 5.5, 3/4 by 1/2 inch black tee. This is going to be pointing down. Our expansion tank's going to go here. And I did this because our piece of threaded rod. Did I lose the threaded rod?
It's right here on top of the board.
Oh, this is all we have in the truck. So it's my own fault, but I want to catch this there and support that properly because I wasn't just sticking it on here and letting the fitting support the tank and its connected accessories. So, you know, it's going down. Sweet. Put our on there. Perfect. Sweet.
You know, he wanted to ask a question, how was combat? I'm like, listen, it's something I don't like to discuss.
I don't blame
you. You know, I don't know you, and I don't want to interfere in anybody's head.
Hanger's there. You know what? I'm going to throw a 3/4 inch press 90 on there and go straight down with the piece that was there. How high off the ground is it now? Is it more than... Yeah, I know.
We're not a code, but...
Yeah, we'll be all right. We'll be fine. All right. Yeah, would you think I was not going to go to the floor?
What's that?
No. I was like, did they think I was not going to go to the floor with the drip leg off the 30 PSI relief valve? Sure. By the way, we have company policy. Anytime we work on an appliance, make sure the right relief valve is on it. Believe it or not, you'll be surprised how many times you run into the wrong ones.
I've had it happen.
Yeah. I had a 100XL on a steam boiler. Yeah, and then I actually took the pressure control off, thinking that there was no pressure in the boiler. Yeah.
That was a mess.
And my hand was red for a... All right, folks. 9:15. Superstar right here, to the right of me.
Thank you.
I called him an older, distinguished gentleman today, and he seemed very, very complimented by the compliment.
Thank you.
You're very welcome.
And I am.
He'll make his debut one day, I promise. All right, as promised, we try to do everything the right way. That expansion tank was in the wrong orientation. We took the valve handle off that ball valve, that IPS half-inch ball valve. We put a cap with a nipple there. Nothing wrong with this. Not going anywhere. We are good to go. And no, it's not dripping. It's just residual water from before. At least we hope so.
It's not dripping.
Okay. We changed the 1/8 inch automatic air valve on top of the Taco air scoop. You know, I don't get it. This is a very expensive boiler. Would you agree?
Absolutely.
Why take a dump on this boiler with such a cheap air scoop that's cast iron and not like a spiral vent? Or
people cut corners to save money.
Yeah, it's crazy.
Certain contractors will do that too.
Yeah, so the expansion tank was in the wrong orientation. It was cocked a little bit. We moved it there. Now, is it the right place for it? Listen, it'd be nice if it was below the air separator and, you know, water, incoming domestic water was here. We had a nice air separator here. We had like the isolation valves for it all, but it looks much better now.
Cleaner, more professional.
But exactly, more professional install. And we're going to take a little Sharpie and we're going to write today's date on that. There you go. We're going to put today's date on it. 8/20/25. Perfect. And we'll take a pen and we'll update the service ticket. And we're going to use today's date on there as well. Yeah, it's annoying. Want to use my, want to use this to lean on it?
I got it.
Okay. Yeah. We're going to update the service tag. By the way, if you want any service tags like that, good luck getting it. The company that I used to use for that, they took a dump on me, so I'm not going to use them anymore. But I need more of those. I definitely need more of those. So anyone who knows where to get those, let me know. Mike@MikeyPipes.com, and I'll order some and I'll give you a shout out. All right. Nicey nice. Okay. Let's check our boiler. We have it firing for domestic hot water right now. This is our, what is that? What is that? Supplier return. That is, that does not look nice.
What?
Whatever this is. Take a look at this.
Yeah, I saw that.
Right? Oof.
Someone doesn't
have to swim by. That is going to the outdoor. That's going to our outdoor cabana and our pool house. Wow. All right. We're going to take a picture of that, put that on our invoice. But it looks like they even tried to spray some Flex Seal on it.
I noticed that too around
the sewer. Oh, my God.
Around the sewer line.
Come on. Yeah, there too. Hacks bring us stacks. Damn. Wow. So, make them aware of that. Okay, back to this. This is our indirect blazing hot. That's our supply. Our return is back there. Let's feel that line.
Hot.
Very nice. We're circulating. We're good. Anytime you work on a boiler like we just did and we shut down the system and We needed to purge all the zones. Most importantly, we don't want any recall. So we're gonna run all the zones. We ran the in-deck. We know that's working because it would suck to get a call tonight. And I got no hot water and you're airbound in the zone. But thanks for watching, folks. Let me get your thoughts and feedback in the criticism section down below or your comments. Try to keep it PG, family friendly. If not, have a nice day. Be well, God bless, stay safe. Thanks for watching.